is Warren Fu. I'm the director on 11th Dimension, and you're watching The Making Of Part 2.
Okay, cut, got it.
Julian actually brought me on board during the early stages of making his album. He wanted to make sure all the visuals not only looked cool, but fit the concepts and themes. Everything so far has been carefully crafted, from the album cover, till the TV and print ads, down to every single logo and font. Naturally, he wanted his first video to also fit the album. The most obvious tie-in is the use of the phrases. Every single song in the album has an associated phrase, but there are also a few new ones that Julian wanted to introduce in the video. But we also had to be careful not to make everything feel too heavy-handed. At the end of the day, we wanted 11th Dimension to just kind of feel fun. Kind of feels like this early MTV video, where it's this weird mix of being both epic and kitschy at the same time. We also wanted all the effects to have that pre-CGI, hand-animated look, type of thing you might find in movies like Ghostbusters. So Julian already knew he wanted to do three different time periods, but we weren't sure how to tie everything together. So we saw this Bruce Lee Game of Death action figure in his manager's office, and that's what sort of inspired us to use the pagoda as a device. If you've seen Julian perform on the road or on TV, you've probably noticed that his band members make cameos in the video.
I think Jeff might have gotten cut, unfortunately. And he was kind of like the Tom Cruise cocktail bartender guy in the 80s scene. I don't know if that shot's going to make it or not. But Danielle and Nelson are both part of our 80s trio. Well, Danielle's drums / percussions. Nelson plays synthesizers, keyboards. JP and Alex. Alex is the drummer. JP, guitarist, the guru, as some people might know. They're playing kind of these parodying post-apocalyptic thugs. The video was shot in LA. We did it in one very long day at, some abandoned, I don't know what it was, studio, factory. It was a cool place.
So during our location scout, I brought a camera with me to take some photos of the potential sets. So I did some artwork over the photos to show the production designer roughly what I had in mind. So the post-apocalyptic scene basically just tells the story of this futuristic composer that desperately just wants to be left alone. We're obviously going for that film noir look with the opera scene, with the high contrast and shafts of light raking across the eyes, just to give it that old Hollywood feel. Most of Julian's videos in the past have been pretty much band performances. I think people must have been pretty surprised to actually see him do a bit of acting in this one. The key ingredients for an authentic looking 80s club scene is to make sure people dress the part, use only pink and blue lighting, use a lot of smoke, and use a lot of hairspray. And you also have to make sure at least one person has the Thriller jacket.